As we count down to the Summer Games in Beijing, we're bringing you a look at the athletes with ties to our area. Tonight, an LSU star who is going for the gold, and some would say also has a heart of gold. WDSU News Channel 6 sports anchor Fletcher Mackel joins us now live with why. Fletcher.
Good evening, Chris. First, let me tell you, I'm live in Jackson with the Saints. We're going to talk about them coming up in sports. But as you said, Olympic sprinter Lolo Jones took in Katrina evacuees back in 2005, so she's dealt with disaster and despair. And now she's returned to her native Iowa to help out with flood victims.
When Lolo Jones ran into thousands of applauding well-wishers, Renee Trout was among them. When Lolo Jones walked into the crowd to give Olympic-style signatures, Renee was right there. When Lolo Jones announced that she was giving a check for $12,000 to a Cedar Rapids flood victim.
Where's Renee at? Yes, you. My money's going to you.
With her $4,000 in winnings from the Olympic trials, along with matching funds from two sponsors.
This is for you, and I hope.
Lolo Jones presented Renee, a complete stranger a minute ago, a check for $12,000.
I'm speechless. Thank you. You have no idea what this means to me and my kids.
And because the Farm Bureau loaned a plane for the occasion, Lolo was able to make a quick trip to Cedar Rapids to see Renee's house, or what's left of
it. It was like someone took my house, shook it, dumped it upside down, and put it back.
Looking out the window with her giant check at her side on her first plane ride ever, only this single mother of two who lost everything last month knows what was on her mind. But Lolo was raised by a single mother with little money, so she knows how it feels to be helped.
I wasn't the parent or anything, but as a kid, I know what it was like to have somebody like, here, you need help, here it is, you know, no strings attached. I don't even want to thank you, like, so I've been there before, so I'm just glad I could, you know, return what somebody did for me many years back.
In Cedar Rapids, they passed block after block of families in limbo as they walked up to the home. The shock that left Renee weeks ago reappeared in Lolo.
Wow.
The home will be rebuilt, hopefully from the foundation up. There was 6 feet of water inside. Renee is living with friends right now, hoping that in a few months, her home will be livable.
Look at me, hurdler. I'm used to overcoming obstacles, and I'm like, how do you even overcome this? Like, where do you start, you know? And she's just, you know, telling me what steps she was taking. But I was just like, for me, I'd just be like, oh my gosh, like, do I kind of throw your hands up? Like, where do you start?
Her check from Lolo is the first recovery money she and her children have received, an unexpected gift from Renee's new favorite athlete.
My faith has been tested beyond belief here in the last month, and to know that there's people that don't even know me that are reaching out to help me is incredible. It's a great feeling.
Again, great job, Lolo Jones. Lolo Jones will be taking part in the 100-meter hurdles in the Beijing Games. We'll hear plenty more from her as the games get closer. And coming up in sports again, we'll hear from the Saints. For now, though, on your side in Jackson, Mississippi, I'm Fletcher Mackel, WDSU News Channel 6.
Very nice story, Fletcher. Thank you. And the Olympic Games begin August 8th right here on WDSU.